Hello and welcome to Team Fortress TV. Sorry for the slight delay there, folks, but we have remedied our technical issues. This is admirable. I'm joined by Twiggy, the mastermind behind these unrestricted show matches, and we got Suyo on the stream tonight doing that beautiful camera work. We're here for Valve's game. It's going to be Zenitsu and Rollerbladers versus Big Boy Bonjour, aka Don't Worry, Be Happy. You've got so many names, they can't decide, Twiggy.
Yeah, they will probably be fixed on some name a bit later. Let's expect some other thing from the former Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory, if someone reminds this.
Oh.
I'm really excited to actually see what games will look like with proper teams. I'm sure they have proper strategies set up for this game.
Yeah, I hope so. I mean, that was the idea behind this. Second run at it, because we were just going to use two mixed teams, and then at the end of the last one last Sunday, Big Zebesai on the interviews, he says, he's going to bring a team, he's going to get six players, he's challenging the rest of European Premiership to try and step to him, and I think he's done pretty well, but no one else was really that interested. Like, we didn't hear anything from Uber Sexuals, they're not playing, and it was up to Kadus, who's forming a new team for season 20. And although he didn't manage to get all six or all five of his current members, he has put together a pretty decent roster there, I think.
Indeed, indeed.
I'm just about to launch the game, but do you know? Do you want to give me a roster rundown there for Zenitsu and Rollerbladers? Can you guess who's playing? What class?
I'm not really guessing because I have the mumble overlay, but I can surely give it a try. So for the Nuts and Rollerbladers, we have Nutson with probably Stay Medic. We have Zebozai, Zapis, Smear, Herpy, and AMS. So we could expect to see AMS on Soldier, probably with Zapis if they play like last week, and Herpy and Zebozai as scout, with Smear stepping up for Rib, who is not here tonight. And for the Big Boy Bonjour team, we have Afikul, Yuhi, Kadus, Captain, Pramzilla, and Talash so far. I have no idea what class Yuhi will play, but as I'm not seeing any main medic on this roster, I'm assuming he would do this by himself, with
You
Kadus
think he's gonna play
staying.
medic?
I don't really know because I don't know who else could do it. Like, maybe Pramzilla?
Yeah, that's what I've heard. Apparently, it's gonna be
Okay.
ETFTL's head admin Permzilla playing medic. Hui's gonna be playing Roamer. Obviously, you got Captain on pocket, Kadus on demo, and then it's gonna be Dalash and Hafiko playing scout. So Dalash is a backup for the team, I believe, or is gonna be next season, but Hui isn't on the roster as far as I know, or he might be a backup. But normally it would be Zub on Roamer, but he is unable to make it tonight, just like Rib on the other team.
Yeah, we can estimate ourselves lucky to have such subs
Remind
because
me
they are
what
still really
happened,
good.
last weekend. What did we see last weekend in the unlocks? What was popular?
Oh, we see kind of some of unlocks being more abused than others. Most importantly, I would say for the scouts unlock, with the critical and the baby face blaster being the standard setup. For most scouts, nobody has opted to try the shortstop despite it being allowed in season 20. But for soldiers, the direct hit has been widely tested and has been considered somewhat viable, as we have seen good soldiers put out decent damage numbers with it, around like 300 damage per minute. But obviously they lost. I mean the splash ability of the rocket launcher, which maybe explain the scouts and baby face blaster dominance. And for demo men, nothing really out of the ordinary for them, as the stock stickies were still the common choice. No charge action, not even lock and load, I guess. So it would be interesting to see if they have something in the bag for this class.
I see Ari, our boy, Ari Canary, is actually planning to run some sort of a raffle. He says he's raffling off a key for every airshot made. I think it's every airshot on the stream. So it's on Sue or a cameraman to capture them as well. I'm having trouble getting my Team Fortress 2 to work correctly right now. But we do have the STV info. I'm going to share that with the Twitch. Twiggy's asking for it as well. This guy hasn't been paying attention. But the teams are on the server. They're basically waiting for me to be able to load TF2 successfully. So, you know, bear with me.
Even if I'm not on TF2, my servers, my TF2 is still working faster than yours.
Send me some good vibes over the internet there. I'm trying to make it work. I'm going to give my PC a good old rub here. I'm going to blow on it.
Give it a blessing, you know, like in data centers.
Come on, old girl, you can do this. Connecting to the server. This is touch and go here, but the difference between this show match this Sunday and the previous one should be that it's going to be a little bit more serious. People were complaining that the previous 12 players didn't take it seriously enough. Although they definitely did play some proper TF2, but these two teams, you know, they're big on team pride. Zebesai wants to win badly. It's going to be a best of three series here, and the first map's just going to be Badlands, and then it's going to be the loser will pick the subsequent maps. But right now, I am in the server. Twiggy, are you here with us too?
Yeah, I'm there as well.
This is absolutely beautiful. Yeah, just need to message them here right now. Kiedis is blowing me up. Kiedis says, give them the Archon. Remember last weekend when Kiedis changed the map too early? Disgusting.
Yeah. So one would hope that after so many years at the top level, they would be aware of this kind of obligations. But I
think they had a good excuse, though. Yeah. Oh. You're right.
They are calling that Gunzilla's PC has crashed, so you're not the only one with a wooden PC.
He must be using the same hacks plugins that I'm using, Twiggy.
Who knows? He's an admin after all. He won't get banned for it.
Yeah, speaking of bans, what's up, bod?
That's when I say, unlike
you're
bod.
You're a French speaker. I don't believe it. I don't trust the ETFTL bans, unless it's a back ban. I don't believe it.
But did you see that Eshock's decision has been to support their player against the ETFTL authority?
Who are you going to trust? On Kaya?
Yeah, this brings a problem because as far as I know, for TF2 there is no a central anti-cheat organization, you know, so that one could say that the ETF2L anti-cheat admin team is biased or something. I don't think so personally, but that's my opinion, and we have no proof of the ban so far. And with this decision from Eshock, we might see an Eshock roster with both attending French LAN Gamer Assembly next spring, which would be a bit strange, you know.
Just for the people who are tuning in here that have no idea what we're talking about, recently a top ETF2L soldier was banned by the ETF2L anti-cheat team, a player called Bod from Belgium. Sort of a human decision, you know, it wasn't by VAC, so I'm questioning it, but I just love to stir up the drama anyway. But we're going to be able to talk about that tomorrow, because we're going to have Permzilla on Fully Charged Europe, our little talking heads chat show. He's going to be there talking about ETFTL's new divisional system that they're planning to bring in for the new season in January. We might be able to ask him about BOD as well. It's going to go live here again, and hopefully we're not going to get another restart round. This could actually be the beginning. So welcome to Team Fortress TV. This is Admirable. I'm here with Twiggy, Sue, and we're here for Valve's game. It's more unrestricted show matches this time. It's the Nuts and Rollerbladers versus Kiedis' team, Big Boy Bonjour. They're onto the first middle here, Twiggy. And Zavis is going ham into Kiedis, but gets absolutely crushed by those pipes. And both medics running quick fix here. They are playing for the win. Look at the position here of Big Boy Bonjour. The blue team all forced into their house there. Can't even get a foothold on middle. And it seems like they're going to have to give up position there and back off and wait for the second fight here, Twiggy.
Yep, nice job by Smear to hold them inside the house. He was on the point with the heal beam on him. But the quick fix is actually popped aggressively to try to catch Nuts, and it works as Kaidus puts two stickies on him and gets the kill. So now with all the speed ability from the blue scouts, they would be able to clean this up without too much of an effort. Is someone in position to put a threat to Permzilla's life? Not at the moment, as Smear is a respawn, I believe. No, he just fled. on risk.
He's trying to spam pipes in there. He's got a sticky trap in house. He goes for the blind debt, but he was just a second too early there. It could have killed off Kui if he had waited. But it's going to be players stacking that spire. Captain tries to jump Permzilla up top, using that feature of the quick fix that allows your medic to jump with your impulse jumps there. Now he's going to jump up to the balcony. Well done. Unlocks in action here. The sticky's on me, and Hafiko opens the door. Spear picks up two. The Lash and Hafiko left with egg on their face there. And now that's going to engage the push out here. Snootsen, Amps, and Zabbis move forward. Zabbis on the low ground sees Captain up on the spire. Captain with a direct hit. It's difficult to jump against that, but he's going to get pushed back slowly and surely. There is still action here. Quick fix being popped off by the blue team, and in fact Zebesai and Smira have gone down here, so they find themselves outnumbered. Oh, big Sandman comes out there, catches Herr P, he won't be able to escape, and there's two scouts and a soldier heading for last, and that's going to be a first round here to the team that are definitely the underdogs. It's Kadus' big boy Bonjour.
Oh yeah, most of this might be done to poor luck for Nutson, dropping the quick fix just before he had it on the mid, and we are back, and I'm seeing a heavy. Help is playing heavy on this mid.
He's been whipped.
He's on the spire. Yeah, he has been whipped. He's on the slope, but he has Huya's Roamer making distraction behind him. But so far, it's not that effective. The heavy is still alive. He's able to crawl his way to the point, and Smear is chasing really aggressively with 50 health onto spire, trying to catch fleeing Permzilla. But Permzilla will survive. But no, it's danger zone because he will have quick fix on last. And quick fix on last is not really the most effective choice, especially considering that the attackers have the heavy. They can quick fix the heavy onto the point and cap while being ubered. So we'll see what they will choose to do. So far they're really cautious because they're crawling their way inside the.
Zebesai is running in through and he's dancing around. There's still four stickies sitting on main there that has refused to debt. So there's a trap there, it might catch them off guard. Zebo's trying to run in bottom right here. He's bringing his medic in, they're just going to stack the point. Quick fix and Babyface Blaster too fast. And they had times three on there in like the blink of an eye. Because the quick fix makes the medic match the speed of his heal target. He was at full speed there with the Babyface Blaster. Just ran in, times three on the point, and they just couldn't react fast enough. Okay, so stickies were on main. Well played, Zebo.
Yeah. We will see this kind of strategy a lot, and we can see that this is already more organized than last week, which is quite good. And this time the BK team using the heavy on slope again is denying every jumper. Look at what they are doing. The heavy staying behind the actual combo in order to deal with any kind of jumping soldier or scout that would try to sneak in. And it works, the quick fix is popped on the grey bridge. Both position for Plumzilla forced to pop the quick fix onto the resupply. Will he have enough quick fix juice to make it out? Yes. And Kadus is jumping on Spire trying to catch Smear. Smear gets destroyed by Captain. But Zebesai is all the way onto Kadus. Kadus is down to one health. Kadus survives. This is probably clutch as the BK team find themselves 3 down. With a heavy on truck, most likely unable to escape as Nutson was using the crossbow. Will Nutson be able to escape? Kadus? No, the Kaber pick. Do we count the Kaber picks into the rifle organized by Ari?
That's an air shot for her. That was a past the count. No, I don't know.
I think we should
Smear coming in fast. Smear's trying to get Kaber revenge onto Permzilla. Comes in from the spawn there. Nobody even saw him. Except for Perm, he was just juking around on the slope there, but does dodge that Kaber hit. But Kadus had tried to jump in with the Kaber the first time, and the heavy was spun up, and he just sort of strafed away. And then after he got healed up, having been on 1 HP, he came in again and managed to get that medic. Big Kaber plays.
Yeah. And we can already notice a slight difference in loadouts for medics, as we can see that Permzilla has 140 health. He's using the Vita, so that helps you keep 20% Uber, up to 20% of your Uber charge when you die. Whereas Nutson has the standard Uber, so as the quick fix is popped on top right for Big Boy Bonjour's team, Nutson is down to 90%, he's on the floor. He's trying to fly with AMS, but he drops up in the process. I think they will be able to hold for now. But good position by Huhi, denying Nutson for coming back up. Huhi is actually behind on the point. Nice job by Nutson and Smear.
Sick arrow, and Kadus is coming up top too. Oh, Smear's in a really difficult position here. His respawn's coming in here. P is rocking
that. Yeah, nice job by Smear.
What do you call that one? Jesus, I'm losing my mind here. The shortstop. I have real trouble trying to use that. I've tried to play with it in a TF2 pickup recently, and I think I went 4 for 16 and then just went back to the scattergun, but it seems really a tricky one to work into your normal scout game, but maybe RP can do it.
What's your feeling about this weapon? Like, do you like it?
It doesn't seem useful in a lot of situations. It doesn't seem to bring much for me, but you know, I'm not a premiership scout. I have noticed though that we're going to see a change up from Permzilla here. He's had enough of this quick fix shenanigans. He's going to run the crits creek. So they're just sitting here, they're buying time for this crits to come up. In comes pressure. Oh, AMS and Zabas both bombing forward, but Captain crushes them with the direct hit there. And meanwhile, the back cap comes in to lash straight down main there. Is going to pull the wool over their eyes, but I think that was just a matter of time before they lost that round. Big plays coming out from Kadus' new team. Big boy, bonjour, big plays.
Indeed. They seem to have practiced at least a bit the unlock strats, and the crit creek is indeed a very good counter to the quick fix, as you can just one shot the med. And this time we have the whipped heavy with the gloves inside the Z instead of the slope, and it's still really effective. It's amazing to see the BK dominance on mid so far, but they haven't been able to concretize their rounds. Let's wish them more luck this time.
Yeah, Zebesai looking very deadly yet again with that babyface blaster. He did seem to favor the scattergun last Sunday, but I think he's been converted to the course.
Maybe
the religion
just didn't. Maybe just didn't have the item.
Yeah. You can of course get these unlocks on scrap.tf if you don't have them, and I see Ari running a raffle through scrap.tf, so keep an eye on Twitch chat for that. They're trying to do the same play here with the babyface blaster scout onto the point. They brought a heavy as well. Hair P there within inches of that point, but there's just so many blue bodies being thrown down there. They have the mini sentry up top as well, and somehow they managed to hold on to it. They were looking for that one this time and they crushed it.
Yeah, thanks to Talash that was blocking the point with the 300 health as heavy, they weren't able to just stack the cap. And this is quite interesting. Assuming your opponent runs quick fix, you can guess they will do this kind of strategy, so that you commit, instead of committing stickies to block the point, you commit one player, and that leaves the stickies to do something else. So this is already an interesting strategic change, as Captain is completely destroyed by RP that used the Sunman on him on the back.
Kadus! Oh! Kadus jumps in with Permzilla in tow there, using the quick fix charge, kills off Knutsen just about there. And they managed to wipe four of those players. Amp's last man alive now, he's going toe-to-toe with Happy Kill, but the Widowmaker is going to claim another victim here. AMS is resting in peace.
Yeah, nice play by Hafik. He wants some more blood. He had the mini sentry inside the house. But we have some Mad Milk action for the BK boys. Kadus has had to wait a bit. Kadus gets obliterated by pipe spam from Smear, who's in a really good position. He gets Permzilla as well. Big play by Smear so far. He's down to 7 head though. And this is a complete GM first, but bear in mind that BK still have the spawn advantage.
Look at the health on these players here. Like,
yeah, Hui is playing Roma without the gun bots. He chose to use the Raitu's Bizon instead. And he finally went down on...
The laser shotgun?
Yeah, what it does is it fires a laser. You have a clip of 4 lasers. It doesn't take ammo to reload. But the lasers can go through people.
Good for choke points. Permzilla and Kadus are on light bulk right now. They're going to back off, but there's action going on around the trash area. Amps is going to take down Captain. Didn't have the heals that time. Oh, Amps just eating a few stickies there, but does survive. He's got heals available from Knutsen, Zappas, and AMS trying to come in here from that lower door. And they are working their way forward, but they're going to be running up against... it's going to be quick fix against Kritzkrieg. The attacking team has crits here, so this could be absolutely devastating, especially if they try and draw them onto the point again. Amps is trying to go in from main as a distraction. He's done it. Zappa's coming in up top. The sticky's dead. It kill him off. But Smear is here with the crits, but he can't get through those stickies. There's a pyro as well. They're just stuck here. It's absolutely disastrous, this push. Quick Kritzkrieg hasn't really done that much at all, but they do have high ground now, just as both charges have faded. They're trying to come in. Zebesai's making a play for the point. He's going to finish off Kadus. Captain's got no rockets out of here. He's all control point. And then on the shotgun, soon onto the point, both scouts there as well. Yeah. And eventually, BK gonna claim another round.
Nice play by BK at the end. I was a bit worried when I saw Smear failing a bit the crit squid, crit squid push. But look at BK using the heavy again. As long as it works, why change it, right? So let's see if the blues have a proper response to it. What will they choose to do with the heavy? The heavy seems to go on the Z again. And look at the point presence for BK. I think Pamzilla is running something else than quick tricks.
Oh no, he's got carpet bomb there. Nitsun got absolutely crushed there as Kadis jumped in with those stickies, killed off two. Then everyone else just followed up on that. You see Thalias there with the babyface blaster killing off Zebesai right at the end. But that was a pretty effective middle, a nice little adaptation there from Big Boy Bonjour.
Was it like they waited for BK to go on the point and then use the quick fix to bomb in with like the whole team?
Yeah, Kadis just raining down damage from on high, and everybody that looked up didn't realize the rest of the team was coming straight across the point at them.
And I think we have a tentative of forward holding by BK to give time for ARP to build the level 3 sentry gun on last.
There's a man behind here, Zebesai is coming onto Spire. Captain senses something is up, or he jumps up there. Zebo goes into Perm, but Perm just steps under the bridge. He's got great cover there from Kadis and Thalash, and the Zebesai threat has been dealt with, but Smear quickly finds a pick on Thalash on the roller door in the lobby. But blue team, Big Bonjour coming in from the bottom right on their perspective. They're trying to make a play for that point. Kadis has got a sticky there, he's pushed the stickies back. The cap is open if they want to go for it, but there's a Wrangle Sentry here and he's unsure what to do. It's still alive there, that Wrangler, super effective. And it does just go down right at the end there. Here comes an Uber though. Sort of panic pop, I think, from Knudsen. He has popped off. His team are alive, except for Zebesai, who's dead again on the respawn. But they need to get the high ground. They need to look for a strong defensive position here. Knudsen's just dicing with death, dancing around on the floor. Hathikul knows he's weak. He's going to run in behind him. He used the bunk here. Do they realize Hathikul's making this big distraction? He's trying to get in onto Knudsen here. He's actually going to go for the demo, and he's putting a few shots into Smear. But meanwhile, the action's happening up top. There's so much going on here. Hathikul's behind distracting. They're doing a great job of covering both flanks here. They defend it off the enemy combo, and now they're going to clean up these players on their left. Thalash and Captain now coming in, making a play for the point. Thalash onto Knudsen, and everyone else just stepped away from him for a second there. And they've taken their eyes off the point, and they find themselves behind around yet again, Twiggy.
Indeed. And this brings the score to 3-2 with 16 minutes left. So this is kind of action-packed, and the quick fix can be used aggressively on last to just stack the caps like we saw before, which is nice for the pace of the game, I would say. And this time no heavy for Happy, but an Afiku with the bonk trying to sneak his way behind. Yes, the babyface blaster is pulling it onto Knudsen, but gets destroyed by AMS. Nice Rocket Spamzilla was down to 8 health before being cleaned by Zapis. Where is Kadis? Kadis
on choke. Kadis on choke. Kui is running through. Hunter is going to come into choke as well, which is probably a terrible timing there as catches some of the damage too. Kadis has gone down to that bomb from Ams. Who is going to die as well. So both those players are going to get that late spawn. They're not going to be up for another 12 seconds. That means it's a 6 versus 4 here as they push forward towards Spire. You see already Zapis is working the flank. Smear is sticking up the lobby and Herp is going to begin to cap, but they're going to realize there's a sniper here. It's going to be Hathikul on the scope, Twiggy.
Indeed, with the Machina he could get some 6 shots. If he ever managed to get 2, that would be so great on 6v6 situation. But nice aggression by Zapis trying to buy time for his team to come, and nice cleanup by Smear. We saw a Mad Milk thrown on the balcony to help Smear and Zapis do the job.
There's
but still no cap
up.
Time. Yeah, the crit is coming up for Pamzilla, and it's a 3-on-3 situation with no cap time so far for the BK team. The crit is popped!
Oh! Gonna get the combo crushed, and that's the thing about that quick fix. It doesn't buff you enough to be able to survive those crit hits, and they just got absolutely smashed there. But they need to be aware that Zapis is in the house. I think Kadis knows about it. He's put a sticky there on Hunter. He knows something is not adding up here. You're gonna see Smear jumping in high, trying to catch them with that caber, and you just see the hesitancy here. Like, they know there's a threat coming in onto Pamzilla. They're gonna try and bait it out, and they get both those players. Great play there from Big Boy Bonjour.
Indeed, as Pernzilla is now hitting 70% crit, so let's expect a crit in less than 10 seconds. Where is the blue combo? The blue combo is crawling his way on Shaw. Cage is aggressively on the Spire. He has health, he can do it. And Nutson is positioned aggressively onto Trash. He might be trapped by Stickies, but the Stickies connect only with Zebozai. Maybe Nutson will be able to escape. But it's a 6-on-4 situation. The Spire will surely be... the big boy bonjours, and we might see a straight push into last once again from bottom left, but this time this is there is no quick fix, so they can't just step in Stickies and expect it to work. But Cadus gets a pick onto Nuts, and I don't know how I didn't see it, but this is danger zone for BK. BK are only two up now, and yeah, Pemzilla gets the cap.
Yeah, it was great focus out there. They just used their mana advantage there. Those two extra players up, and Cadus was just trying to float a few Stickies over as scout pressured from the top as well, and there wasn't much Knutson could do there. He was just being attacked from all angles, but I mean, really, BK shouldn't have been so far forward on Trash, taking that fight when they were outnumbered and outcrits. But it is onto another middle here, the seventh of this map so far. It's 4-2 in favour of Cadus' big boy Bonjour. Herpy running the heavy weapons guy. Really showed himself up top, trying to flank onto the slope here. Ninja Heavy coming up. It's the Bat Scout. He's going to take out the Devil Man. He's onto the Medic as well. Huge Heavy plays. Airshots coming out there from Ams as he plucks Captain from the sky. And that was a bizarre middle.
Herpy has one, had one health, but he unfortunately ran into Huhi, who was behind on the house.
Big serve from Knutson as well there. Saves himself into the balcony. Picks up the... He didn't even get the kit. He's just going to walk forward here with a quick fix. But that was an excellent middle. Very entertaining.
But no, they have to convert it.
Because they both try to go for the hero Sandman shot there, but just ends up dying foolishly. These unlocks, man, they make people do crazy things.
Yeah, indeed. But so far, it's only affecting the pace of the game positively, you know? The game is way faster than what I'm used to see these days. And the quick fix is actually popped. They're trying to go main, but Nutson goes into 8 Stickies and dies with the quick fix. No, Nutson, you can't tank 8 Stickies straight on.
He thinks he's running Uberman. He's like, yeah, I can survive 8 Stickies, no problem, but no. He hasn't read the instructions on that quick fix. Herpy's taking a fight of Trash here against 2 scouts, but doesn't look like he's going to be able to win that one, and his team are 2 players down right now.
Yeah.
It's going to be tricky for them. The Emissai is going to commit though, and he's getting absolutely shrecked by Hafiko. Flash comes in and steals that frag. And 3 players down right now. Herpy about to get back on the field, but if BK keep losing players like this and are always at a man disadvantage, doesn't matter what unlocks you're using, you're just going to struggle.
Do you want to hear some team comps for BK to see how they will adapt to this incoming Uber from Cadus and his boys?
I totally forgot we had those team comps.
Level jack, I'm
Alright, done.
Oh, so many rollers! I died. Free up though, go!
Scout, Solar points.
Up. Get middle.
Solar house. Solar
get
house.
Middle. I took
a hit. Just
nice.
I'm gonna reset.
We have to start capping. We have to start capping now, guys. They're gonna spawn into free. The control point is 2 yes spawn, medic and something else. I'm spawning a 1. I spawn.
I'm back spawning for you. Behind you.
Yeah. Go through Shulk now so you can rocket jump with me.
That is gonna top in. No way.
Yeah, forget expecting it.
You get so much more boost than me, it's crazy.
Yeah, I know. I'm coming out of shot, guys.
Soul shot.
I think we can just go in.
We can jump you in.
Jump in with a solo or something.
No, go.
Six
we're in. Rocket jump.
Surely it's weak as fuck.
Captain is weak.
Demoted.
Nice.
Going on point.
Let's go.
Stop back.
Come on, middle.
Behind is gonna come house or show. Scuff at it on me.
Yeah, I'm
Sabre Shield.
Or do I see right? Yeah.
Solly on me! Direct hit, shit!
No, I just slipped out of
there. Let's go, go to right! Go!
The control point is being
contested. Oh my god, you can't kill me!
Can you kill him?
Oh my god!
I like it's super hard aim at this.
Yeah, I know.
Because you run so fast. Like, I'm not used to it at all.
This nuts.
Oh my god. That was incredible. Like, Knutson's really doing a good job of adapting to using the quick fix there. Like, he's getting a soldier to sync the rocket jumps with him so he can get good distance and stuff.
He sounds like he's having a lot of fun.
Yeah, yeah. That was incredible. We're on to another mid though, and the game has been getting a little bit closer, one round in it right now. Kairos is working the enemy closet, he's trying to come through there. He's going to jump with Permzilla. Permzilla doesn't get quite the distance there, but Kairos is in onto Smearier, trying to take this demo man one on one. Main one, Captain's gone down to Smearier with that sticky trap playing around the shithouse there. There's action going on in the point. Huey's coming in from behind, it's just Smearier and Zebesai. Zebo's coming back in with that fully charged Babyface Blaster. He's going to get the 2k there, gets Huey and Hafikul, keeps his demo man in the game, but Flash is playing around there. And Zebo's running that Pretty Boy's pocket pistol too, so he's got 140 health here. It's looking grim for Thalash. He's forced him underneath the bridge there. He somehow managed to run out past Mira there, but Zebo just catches him. Like, must have been one pellet there caught him as he ran through the house, and he does manage to finish him off, and they have secured that mid-fight, Twiggy.
Indeed. So they have a nice chance of bringing the score to 4-4. If only they would use a short circuit engineer with a quick fix to run on inside the point. They would give up, they would like, destroy the city with it. And no, Captain, yeah. Captain and Huey are going huge. Huey is just trying every bazooka up at his disposal. I saw him with Liberty Launcher. And look at this Kairos and Permzilla pushing from Valley Street to the BK train. Onto Chuck, forcing BK to go all the way back. Because they are too down. Kairos wants some more blood. This is cool, mate. You're not forced to go into the bottlenecking choke now. When you want to push mid, you can just go Valley and jump.
Oh, both medics jumping in and popping their charges here. Kairos with the stickies and AMS and Knutson jumping forward with that rocket launcher.
Oh, Permzilla failed the jump and gets destroyed by Zebozai and Zapis. And okay, this is in the danger zone.
Seems like it was, but yeah, better synchronization there from BK, but they've missed one thing. Happy kills on the back cap, but he realizes the numbers aren't in his favor. We're gonna get the stun again! Whips out the old Sandman. That was the second one he got in this life. This time he kills off AMS. He does trade though. I see Huey coming from Valley as the combo of BK have already moved through choke here. Huey is undetected. He's going to jump with that direct hit, but nobody's listening. They haven't heard it. He's walking in behind the medic now. He's going to jump again. He's on to Knutson here. He needs to hit a magic shot. Gets him down to 90, but can't connect the second one, and there's no one there to support his damage. And already Zebo and Knutson so fast with that quick fix. Scout Babyface Blaster combo already running in behind here, creating havoc on the flank. And Zebo, never mind the fact that he already has 140 health, if he just has those constant heals as well, how are you supposed to deal with that, Twiggy?
I don't know, I think you have to kite like Big Boy Bonjour did, but in the end the numbers were too big for BK. But yeah, you only have 4 shots loaded anyway as Scout when you have the Babyface Blaster, so you can just tank the damage that he's dealing, I guess, if you have your own quick fix, or you can use Jarati or stuff like that to out damage the. And we have a Scout on last. Yes, Zebozai is already on the blue last. He gets the flash cap.
He's everywhere.
Yeah. 1 second ago, he was on bottom. He was on Grey Bridge. I mean. And next
that's 4-4, man. 4-4. Yeah. And there's 5 minutes, 45 seconds left.
What do we do if there is a tie? Do we do a golden cap?
Golden cap. It's the only way. Oh, look at this rollout from Kairos and Perm going
choke again. We have a pyro!
Zappas is up fast, he's already got Kairos and Permzilla locked into that choke. Captain comes out of the house though, Kairos gets first blood onto Zappas, but Amsebo and Smear follow up with 3 frags of their own. The pyro gets the big reflect, hairpin onto Huey there. And the Lash is behind enemy lines away on the red side of the map, but he's being hounded by Zebo. He's on 5 health here, he needs to go huge. If he wants to be able to finish off Zebo, and he won't be able to, he tries to run, but both scouts are just so fast. It doesn't even matter, he's going to go down, and it looks like BK will take this mid. Do we want to perhaps hear a few BK team comms as they try to break this last defense?
Let's go.
I think we're favouring them, but they make it fun.
Pyro.
Hey, you can just run with me, because you get the advantage from my lead.
Fall down.
Let's go balcony, lobby, sorry.
Oh, yeah, we need to catch.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
We should go from main with the quick fix, because we can jump top left.
Yeah, okay. So, please, you want to go with us?
No.
No, let's go. Okay. We're going through
cut
the main.
Cut right back behind us.
Fucking center.
It's so, what the fuck. We can't short circuit, so.
Yeah, we didn't do much with it.
It's
catching my nose. What's going on? We need to fall.
Where are we?
Sub-region.
We're going back to Grey, I guess.
He's scratching his nose. Knudsen, I repeat, is scratching his nose.
It's time to focus him.
And you know, they went in there totally unprepared. Did you see that Cadis was used in the Scottish Resistance? He had traps up in two places.
Scottish Resistance plus loose cannon to bump the quick fix, the incoming quick fix. And let's not forget that Scottish Resistance stickies can destroy incoming stickies. So they had the Scottish Resistance plus the short circuit to deny any kind of explosive damage that quick fix could have done. But no, Cadis has nothing to defend himself, because the loose cannon is awful to self-defense, but he had like...
He gets another one!
Yeah, he had 10 stickies on the same door, and wasn't dating the stickies all together. And he got the demo man, and now we have the quick fix popped by Nelson. Nelson is trying to get his quick fix again by sawing the pyro, but no. The postal pummeler is too strong for Huey, and the cleanup is real.
If Huey just switched up to that crit melee first, like, it's three people on fire and he tried to burn them all down, but if he'd actually just gone for the three melee hits, he might have been able to save Permzilla there. But yeah, there's an enemy pyro on the field as well. Look at this attempt at play coming in, a little bit of bait from Zebesai, but Herpy reacts a little bit slowly. Yeah. He's not going to be able to catch that scout off guard, and he's going to get gunned down by Thalash there, but there's already action coming in on main as well. I'm just going to jump the point, but there's eight Scottish Resistance stickies on there. Oh no, it's normal stickies in fact. Cadis does dead, and Smear's just going to step onto the point, but there's not
he
enough damage left.
He stepped on the stickies and didn't die! He has 16 health left. I think Cadis could be a bit mad. Do you want to go to Big Boy Bonjour's gun?
Yeah. I think we need to be a bit more diplomatic here, give these guys a look in.
But we need more people. Just focus the same areas. I'm house, go valley. Gonna jump earlier this minute, demo's house. Place back of his train, gonna jump that demo
jump
if you can.
I jumped there.
They're in valley.
I'm set.
Nice, got it.
Mess up.
Focus on
I'm dead.
It's just us.
It's just us. Back. I know we're on the wrong side, yeah, but we get quick fix, maybe.
Somebody's gone.
That was my bad.
Yeah.
I wanna go sniper.
That did not work out from there.
Okay, this, yeah. He had no idea where to look against the babyface blaster scout. Was trying to predict the play, but in the end it didn't work.
Yeah, and the demo man, but even though Cadis had done damage to Smear, like Smear was set up there and actually got that early pick. Was it onto Kui who jumped up first?
I think so.
So even though he did go down, he made it
look at what BK is gonna do. Look, BK has a heavy with the Fist of Steels. If they just wait for the heavy.
Like Airshot onto Kui there, who's gonna run towards his own spawn with the escape plan. Hafikul trying to challenge a heavy on Spire, a scout is difficult, but Hui was trying to come in from behind there, ended up getting Airshot, and Delphi has survived. He's trying to. Oh! Big direct hit onto Knudsen there! Catches the medic, and such damage, even from range there.
I think Knudsen can thank AMS for the jump that made him take full damage and land just in front of the rocket spam completely randomly. But I was so hyped to see a quick fixed Fist of Steel heavy run into the point and just staying alive. But this won't happen now.
Oh, here comes Smear from behind. He's using the parachute. He's popping out the damage here. He's gonna get the force on the Permzilla. Perm didn't know what was happening there.
There's only 20 seconds left, and it's a regular weapon used by Permzilla. If they want to score the run and bring it to a golden gap, they have to be really quick. And AMS and Nutsun are saying no to this. They are blocking the Spire. Suppose I get the pick on Cadis and Permzilla, and this will be the first map for BK as they are retaking this mid.
Yeah, there it is. 3, 2, 1, and that's going to be a win for BK. And I believe the rules are going to be that the losing team gets to pick after each map. So the next map coming up, I imagine, is going to be Big Boy Bonjour's pick. But if you just join us here on Team Fortress TV, you missed the first map of this unrestricted show match. It's Valve's game. This is all the unlocks in a 6v6 format. We've got the sort of usual European class limits you're allowed. Two soldiers, two spies, two scouts. But it is one of everything else. But that was a good first half. I guess we got to check out the logs, man. See what the stats tell us, Chuggy.
I'm trying to get them, yeah. Still loading so fast.
I'm gonna whip open See if I can beat you in this race. I've got the logs copied from chat.
I have them Follow as it. Well.
Oh, yeah, it's up on my screen. I'm going straight to the damage stat. 500 damage per minute for K Dizzle.
52 kilos.
Let me see how effective are those unlocks. No damage with the loose cannon, according to logs, or 200. 600 damage with the Scottish resistance, but mostly the sticky launcher still proven to be super effective. And
especially when your medic can follow you like Pumzilla did.
The frags don't add up there. It says he has 52 kills. No, yep. Wait, they do. I can't do math. It's okay. No problem.
I think it's right.
Look at the air shots here. AMS, 11 air shots, and he was mostly running the normal rocket launcher. And I noticed that last week that I actually thought the number of air shots was lower, despite, you know, some sort of thinking there that direct hit produces more air shots, but it seems like the normal rocket launcher produces more.
Yeah, I guess the players are just used to the rocket speed of the regular launcher.
Yeah, true, yeah. That's true.
And now that less soldiers were using the DH, we see so far less borderline OP stats for the scouts, as we have only Zebozai breaking the 300 damage per minute mark. Most likely a big credit to his team with his performance, but Hafikul and Talash, 270 damage and 240 respectively, which is
that's crazy. Look at the damage. Yep. Like there's how many? 5 players in the server with over 300 damage per minute there.
The quick fix can heal so much more than the so that the players.
Yeah, look at those heal stats.
Yeah. Over 1,000, I think it's doable with the regular medigun, isn't it? In regular matches.
But you get anything up to about 13,000 if you're having an incredible game.
But no, I think it's common to have more than 1,000 with a quick fix. Look at how many quick fix charges have been popped. 11 for Pumzilla, 13 for Nutson. So yeah, if the medics heal more, it pushes the players forward as they think they are healed. Ultimately, they take more damage. But the BK game style was revolving a lot on non-ubered quick fix pushes. They were just trying to, you know, jump in and bring more numbers to some areas on the maps.
And yeah, so far, it makes it really interesting, actually, because, you know, Demoman, even whenever you have charge, the Demoman playing around a choke point is often not going to focus the first guy through. He's going to focus the medic and make sure he can't get in. But if your medic just jumps over those stickies, like, yeah, there's not much you can do. And you saw whenever Amps and Knutson went in, Zebesai was able to just run through the stickies as well. So they had 3 players in free, just because they decided to go, and they had a well-timed jump there. That really caught Big Boy Bonjour off guard. That
and
one that we had the comms for as well.
And afterwards, it's just purely DM. You can't just abuse the fact that you can spam chokes with stickies. So I think that just makes the KG's performance more impressive overall. You know, being able to put that much damage per minute against a team that is so much more mobile than what we're used to see. Quite impressive, in fact. Maybe it was also because he got 42% of the heals, which in turn might be a reason why his team lost.